Welcome to this instruction video. For this tutorial, I have permission from Catherine Bly to explain another blanket of her, the Secret Garden. This blanket has 9 different flower squares and a square with a key. And this is the key to the Secret Garden. I do my best to explain the squares step by step, and if you want to see the written pattern, then visit the website from Catherine. The link is below this video. The yarn that we use is Starcraft Special Double Knit, and I use a 4mm crochet hook. I hope you like this tutorial, and we're going to start. You need to make 16 of these squares, 8 in color combination A and 8 squares in color combination B. In this tutorial, I'll show you the color B combination. Round 1, and we start with a magic circle. And we start with a chain 1 stitch. And then in the magic circle we work 5 single crochets. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now pull on the short tail to close the magic circle and make a slip stitch in your first single crochet to close this round. Don't cut the yarn. In the next round we use the same color. Round 2, and we start with a chain 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And the first 3 chain stitches counts for a double crochet, and the fourth stitch counts for a chain 1 stitch. In the same stitch, go back with your needle in the same stitch with a double crochet. Now you have in one and the same stitch a double crochet, a chain, and a double crochet. Now in the next 4 stitches we work a double crochet and chain 1 and a double crochet in that same stitch. 3 more times to go. In the next stitch a double crochet and chain stitch, and go back in that same stitch with a double crochet. 2 times a double crochet and chain and a double crochet in that same stitch. And in the last stitch a double crochet and chain and a double crochet. And now we work a slip stitch in the third single of the third chain stitch. 1, 2, and 3. In that stitch we work a slip stitch to close this round. In the next round we use the same color. Round 3. And we start with a chain 3 stitch. 1, 2, 3, and this counts for a double crochet. Now we work a 4 double crochet cluster in the next chain 1 space. And that's here in that chain 1 space for a double crochet twice over. And then go to the chain 1 space and we work there a 4 double crochet cluster in that space. Pick up your thread, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2. Now we stop, twice over, go back to that same space, pick up your thread, yarn over, pull through 2, and yarn over, and pull through 2. 2 more times, twice over. Back in that same space, pick up your thread, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2, and 1 more to go, twice over, Go back in that same chain 1 space, pick up your thread, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2. Now you have 5 loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through all of that 5 loops. Now you have a 4 treble crochet cluster and a double crochet. In the next stitch, we work a double crochet, and that's the stitch next to the chain 1 space. In that first double crochet here, we work a double crochet. Now chain 3, 1, 2, 3, and a double crochet in the next stitch. It's in the next double crochet on the top, and double crochet. And now we work a new treble crochet cluster, a 4 treble crochet cluster in the next chain 1 space, twice over, and then go to the next chain 1 space and make a 4 treble crochet cluster. It's 1, 2, splitting, it's 3 and 4. 5 loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through. In the next stitch, and that's the stitch next to the chain 1 space, in that first double crochet, a new double crochet. And now we chain 3, 1, 2 and 3, and in the next stitch also a double crochet. Go so all the way around. In the next chain 1 space we make a new cluster. 5 clusters in total. I make my last cluster. Now in the next stitch a double crochet. And now we have to make a chain 3, 1, 2, 3, and go to the first double crochet, and that's your chain 3 stitches, and in the top of that chain 3 stitch we make an invisible join. Cut the yarn and we open that stitch, and with a needle we make it invisible join. Here's your first chain 3. We skip those stitches, and then in the next stitch, and that's on the top of that cluster stitch, we make that invisible join. And then go back to the last chain stitch in the top and pull through. And now work, wave that thread in on the back of your work. Round 4, and we start with a new color. And we begin with a standing single crochet in a double crochet next to that cluster stitch here. On the right, the first double crochet for that cluster stitch. In that stitch, a standing single crochet. And now we make a front post single crochet around the next stitch, and the next stitch is then that cluster stitch. Around that cluster, from the front to the back, around that 4 double crochets, and then from the back to the front. And now we work a single crochet around that cluster in the next stitch, and that's the double crochet from the left of your treble cluster. In that stitch we work also a single crochet. In the chain 3 space we work 4 single crochets, 1, 2, 3, and 4 in the next stitch, and that's on the top of that double crochet and single crochet. Then a front post single crochet around that cluster. So around the 4 double crochets in that cluster and make on the front a single crochet. In the next stitch, and that's in the next stitch of that double crochet, we work also a single crochet. And in the next chain 3 space, 4 single crochets. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And go so all the way around. I'll show you the repeat once more. In the next stitch above the double crochet, we work in that stitch a single crochet and a front post single crochet around that treble cluster. And in the next stitch from the double crochet, we work a single crochet. And in the next chain 3 space, 4 single crochets. Go so all the way around and then make a slip stitch in the beginning. I made all the stitches and now we work a slip stitch in the beginning in the first standing single crochet with a slip stitch. In the next round, we use the same color. Round 5, and we start with a chain 1. And in that same stitch where you make that slip stitch in front of that previous round, we work a single crochet in that same stitch. And now in the next stitch, we work 2 single crochets, and that's that must be in the stitch of that front post single crochet. That's your checkpoint. 2 single crochets in that stitch. Now in the next 6 stitches we work a single crochet. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And then in the next stitch, and that should be on the front post single crochet, we work 2 single crochets in that same stitch. 1 and 2. And go so all the way around. In the next 6 stitches, a single crochet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And in the next stitch, on the top of that front post single crochet, we work 2 single crochets in that same stitch. 1 and 2. And in the beginning we work a slip stitch. I'm almost done with this round. I have to make 5 more single crochets. In my last stitch I work 2 single crochets in that same stitch of that front post single crochet. And now we have 5 stitches over, and in the that 5 stitches we work a single crochet, but it must be 6 single crochets. In the beginning we work 1 single crochet, and that makes 6 stitches together. In the next 5 stitches a single crochet. And then we make a slip stitch in your first single crochet to close this round. And in the next round we use the same color. Round 6, and we start with a chain 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And this counts for a double crochet and a chain 3 stitch. Now we work in that same stitch where you made that slip stitch of the previous round and double crochet. Now we have a double crochet, a chain 3, and a double crochet. And this is your first corner of your square. In the next 4 stitches we work a double crochet. Let's go to the next stitch. This is 1 and go to the next stitch. 2 and to the next. 3 and 4. Now we have to make a chain and now we skip 1 stitch and then in the next 4 stitches we work also a double crochet. So yarn over and skip 1 stitch and in the next 4 stitches a double crochet. 1, 2, 3 and 4. And now we have to make a new corner in the next stitch and double crochet. Chain 3, 1, 2 and 3 and then in the same stitch and double crochet for a new corner. And now after the first corner here, repeat all those stitches 3 more times and then make an invisible join to close this round. I'm done with all the stitches and I cut the yarn and open up the stitch and now we work an invisible join. This is your chain 6 and we skip the first 3 chain stitches. 1, 2 and 3 and then in the 4th stitch we work that invisible join. Go under that V stitch, pull through and now go back to the last double crochet you made and in the top of that double crochet pull through and it's your invisible join. Round 7 and we start with a new color and we begin in the stitch for the corner space. Here's your 3 chain corner space and then that stitch for the corner space in that double crochet on the top we work a standing double crochet. Now in that corner space we make a new corner. We start with a 3 double crochet cluster. Yarn over and go to that chain 3 space. Pick up your thread. Yarn over and pull through 2. Now stop. Yarn over. Go back to that same space. Pick up your thread. Yarn over and pull through 2. Stop again. Yarn over, go in that same corner space, pick up, yarn over and pull through 2. 4 loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through all of your loops. And that's a 3 double crochet cluster. Now in chain 3, 1, 2 and 3 and we go back in that same corner space with another 3 double crochet cluster. Yarn over and go in that corner space and make that cluster. This is 1. Go back in that same space. 2. And 3. 4 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through. Now in the next 4 stitches we work a double crochet and also in that first stitch here next to the corner in that little stitch here we work also a double crochet. This is 1. Now go back or go to the next stitch. That's 2 and in the next stitch 3 and in the next stitch 4 double crochets. Now in the next stitch and that's the double crochet for that chain 1 space we work a new cluster. and 3 double crochet cluster in that stitch. That's 1, 2, and 3. Yarn over and pull through. Now we work a three treble crochet cluster into the skipped stitch from round 5. Here's your chain 1 space and under that chain 1 space, in that stitch here, in that skipped stitch, that is round 5, we work that 3 treble crochet cluster. Yarn twice over and now go to that round 5 and pick up that stitch and work around that stitch and fold your chain 1 space to the back. Work not in those 2 loops here, only in the stitch of round 5. So pick up your thread, your stitch, and fold your previous round to the back. Pick up your thread, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2. Now yarn twice over and go back to that same stitch. Pick up, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2. Yarn twice over, go back to that same stitch. Yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2. 4 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through. Now we skip the next stitch and that's the chain 1 space here. And in the next stitch we work, and that's in the first double crochet here after that chain 1 space, we work a new cluster and 3 double crochet cluster in that stitch. 1, 2, 3, yarn over and pull through. In the next 4 stitches we work a double crochet. It's 1, and in the next stitch 2, 3, and 4. And now in the next corner we make a new corner. We begin with a 3 double crochet cluster in that corner space. 1 and 2 and 3 double crochet cluster. Now chain 3, 1, 2, and 3, and we work another 3 double crochet cluster in that same corner space. 1, 2, and 3, and make that cluster. And this is the same corner than the first corner. Repeat after the corner here all those stitches 3 more times and then make an invisible join to close this round. I made here my 3 last clusters and now we have to make 3 double crochets. In the first stitch we work also a standing double crochet and that makes 4 together. In the last 3 stitches a double crochet. 1, 2, and 3. And now cut the yarn. And we make that invisible join. We skip the first standing double crochet here and we go always to the next stitch, and that's this little stitch for the cluster. Go in that stitch, front to the back, and pull through and work around that first standing double crochet and go to the last double crochet in the top and pull through. new color of 4 round 8 and we start in a chain 3 corner space with a standing single crochet. In that same space we work a single crochet and now a chain 3, 1, 2 and 3 and go back to that same corner space with 2 single crochets, 1 and 2, and that's your new corner. In the next stitch you make a front post single crochet and that's around that cluster stitch here and go around that cluster and then on the front we make that single crochet. In the next 4 stitches, and that is the next 4 double crochets, on the top we work a back post single crochet. So around that first double crochet and then on the back of your work we work that single crochet. That's 1, and go to the next stitch, around the post, on the back and make that single crochet. That's 2. And then the next stitch, 3, and the next stitch, 4. 4 back post single crochets. Now in the next 3 stitches we work on front post single crochet and that must be the 3 cluster stitches here. Around that first cluster stitch on the front and make that single crochet. Around the next cluster and then on the front make a single crochet. Around the next cluster and make that front post single crochet. In the next 4 stitches, and that is the 4 double crochets here, we work a back post single crochet. So around that next stitch, the next double crochet, around that stitch and on the back that single crochet. That's 1, and go back to of go to the next stitch and on the back and single crochet and in the next and back post single crochet and in the next and back post single crochet. 4 back post double crochets. Now a front post single crochet around the next cluster. So around that cluster and then on the front make that single crochet. And now a new corner in that chain 3 corner space, 2 single crochets in that space, 1 and 2. Now chain 3, 1, 2, 3 and in that same corner space 2 single crochets. And this is the repeat of this round. After this corner here, repeat all the stitches 3 more times and then make an invisible join to close this round. Round 9 and a new color is on my hook and we start with a standing double crochet in the stitch for the corner. This is your corner and then in the stitch for the corner we make that standing double crochet. And now in that corner space we make a new corner and that's the same corner as in round 7. In that corner space we make a 3 double crochet cluster. It's 1, 2 and 3 double crochet, yarn over and pull through. New cluster. Now we chain 3, 1, 2, 3 and go back in that same corner space with a new 3 double crochet cluster. In the next 7 stitches we work a double crochet. Yarn over and go to that first stitch, and that's the stitch directly next to the corner space in that little stitch here. That's your first stitch. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Now in the next stitch, and that should be on the top of that cluster here, in that little stitch here, we work a new cluster, and 3 double crochet cluster. So on the top of that cluster of round 7, and then in the stitch of that front post single crochet, there you make that new cluster. Now we chain 1 and we skip the next stitch, and that's the stitch above the treble crochet cluster. That stitch we skip that, and in the next stitch, and that's above the next cluster, in the 3rd front post single crochet, we work a new 3 double crochet cluster. And between the 2 clusters we made that chain 1. In the next 7 stitches we work on double crochet. This 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And that was the last stitch for the corner space. And in that corner space we make a new corner. Make a 3 double crochet cluster in that corner space. Chain 3, 1, 2, and 3, and go back in that same space with a new cluster, a double crochet, 3 double crochet cluster. And this is the same corner than the first corner, and repeat all stitches after the first corner here. Repeat all those stitches 3 more times and make an invisible join to close this round. Round 10, and we start with a new color, and we begin with a standing single crochet in a corner space. In that same space, a single crochet. Now we chain 3, 1, 2, and 3, and in that same corner space, 2 single crochets. 1 and 2 for a new corner. In the next stitch, we make a front post single crochet, and that's around that cluster stitch here. On the front, we make that front post single crochet. And now we make a back post single crochet in the next 7 stitches. And your first stitch is that first double crochet here. Around that double crochet, on the back, make that back post single crochet. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Now on the next stitch, and that's that cluster, we make a front post single crochet. So around that cluster, on the front and make that front post single crochet. In the chain one space we work a single crochet and around the next cluster stitch we work a front post single crochet around the post, around that cluster, on the front, that front post single crochet. And now on the next 7 stitches we work a back post single crochet, so around that first double crochet here next to the cluster stitch on the back, and work that single crochet. Oops, once more, around that first double crochet on the back, that back post single crochet. This is 2, and in the next 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And now around that corner cluster stitch here, we work another front post single crochet around that post, that cluster, and make that single crochet. In that chain 3 space, corner space, we work 2 single crochets, 1 and 2. Now chain 3, 1, 2, and 3. And go back in that same space in the corner with 2 single crochets. And this is the repeat. You go all the way around. After the corner here, repeat all those stitches 3 more times and make an invisible join to close this round. A new color in round 11. And you begin with a standing double crochet in the stitch 4, the corner space. And then double, standing double crochet. In that corner space we make a new corner, and that's the same corner as the 2 white color corners here. In the 3 chain space we work that new 3 double crochet cluster. Now chain 3 and go back in that same corner space with a new 3 double crochet cluster. In the next 11 stitches we work a double crochet, and your first stitch is that little stitch here, the first single crochet next to the corner. In that stitch is your first double crochet, the first of 11. This is 1. Go to the next stitch, 2, and in the next stitch 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. And that last double crochet must be on the stitch of that front post single crochet around that cluster. The next stitch we make a 3 treble crochet cluster into that skipped stitch of round 8, and that's the stitch under that single crochet here between the 2 clusters. In that stitch here under of round 8, there we make that 3 treble crochet cluster. Twice over from treble and go to that stitch and pick up that stitch, only that stitch, and fold your work to the back to create more space and make that three treble crochet cluster. Spun twice over and go back in that same stitch. Two, twice over and go back in that same stitch. Three, four loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through. Now skip the next stitch and that's the single crochet in that chain one space. We skip that stitch and in the next stitch we work a new double crochet. And that's the first of 11. This is one. Go to the next stitch. Two. In the next. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. 10 and 11. And that last double crochet must be in that stitch for the corner space. In the corner space, we make a new corner with a 3 double crochet cluster. Now we have to make a chain 3, 1, 2, and 3 and go back in that same corner space with a new 3 double crochet cluster. And now we repeat all the stitches after the first corner here. All those stitches 3 more times all the way around and make an invisible join to close this round, and then we have to one row more round to go and then we're done with the square. Round 12, and this is the last round and we begin with a new color with a standing single crochet in any corner space. In that same corner space we work 3 single crochets. 1, 2 and 3. This is your new corner. In the next stitch we work a front post single crochet and that's the cluster here. Around that cluster we made that front post single crochet. In the next 11 stitches we work a back post single crochet and your first stitch is that first double crochet here next to the cluster stitch, and on the back we work that single crochet. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 8, 9, and 10, and last stitch 11. Now we work 2 half double crochets in the skipped stitch from round 10. And when you look on the back of your work, you see here that little dark green loop, and in that stitch we work that 2 half double crochets. Yarn over and go to that stitch on the back and make that half double crochet. Yarn over and go back in that same stitch for another half double crochet. And in the next 11 stitches we work also a back post single crochet, and the first stitch is here that first double crochet next to that cluster stitch, around that double crochet, and on the back you work that single crochet. It's one, two, and three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10 and 11, and that's the last double crochet here. Now in the next stitch, and that's around that cluster, we make a new front post single crochet. So around that cluster and make that front post single crochet, and now in that corner space we work five single crochets. I'm sorry. It's one, two, three, four, and five, for a new corner. And this is the same corner than your first corner. And repeat all the stitches here after the corner three more times. 11 back post single crochets, and we have one more stitch to go, and that's a front post single crochet around that last cluster stitch. And now we cut the yarn and open up that stitch, and we work the last invisible stitch of this square. This is your first standing single crochet, and we skip those stitch. We go always to the next stitch. We work always around the first stitch. Let's go to the next stitch and work in that last stitch you made, and that's that front post single crochet around that cluster, and in the top of that stitch pull through. And now on the back of your work you weave your thread in, and we're done with the square. And now you have to make 8 of these color B and 8 in the color A combination. Thank you for watching, and see you next time. Bye.